court's now in session. Please take a seat. Okay. Item one on the calendar, CR 10-7253, United States of America versus... Defendant has requested to use the name Saul Goodman. So it's United States versus Saul Goodman. Counsel, please state your appearances.
AUSA George Castellano. With me is Elizabeth Nuriani, trial attorney from the Drug Enforcement Section of the Department of Justice. AUSAs Sarah Braddock, Neil Patel, and Hillary Park, and Special Agent in Charge Austin Ramey from the DEA. Also present in the courtroom, Zachary Hernandez, Special Agent in Charge of the FBI in New Mexico. Your Honor, I'd also like to note the presence of the victims who are here this morning, Marie Schrader and Blanca Gomez.
William Oakley appearing as advisory counsel, Saul Goodman appearing on his own behalf. Good morning.
The defendant still wants to represent himself?
That's right, Your Honor.
Okay. The parties have reached a plea agreement satisfactory to both sides. However, I have reviewed the government's sentencing recommendations and, well, I have questions. Mr. Castellano, will you please come up to the microphone? Mr. Castellano. Today, we consider the sentence for a defendant who will be pleading guilty to multiple felonies, RICO offenses, money laundering, conspiracy, accessory after the fact to the murder of federal officers. And for these offenses, the government's sentencing recommendation is 7 years.
Your Honor, I can assure you my colleagues and I gave every aspect of this recommendation careful consideration.
Help me understand. Has the defendant provided substantial assistance to the government?
Your Honor.
Mr. Oakley, please advise your client to stay silent at this time.
Your Honor, with respect, Mr. Oakley is advisory counsel. I'm representing myself here today. If I may say something that I think will help the court fully understand the situation.
Mr. Goodman, you are the beneficiary of the most generous sentencing recommendation I've seen in 22 years on the bench. Any statement you make imperils that recommendation.
I'm very aware of that, Your Honor. If you'll allow me to speak, I think I can save the court's valuable time.
Go ahead. Briefly.
Years ago, a man came into my office. He said his name was Mayhew. He wanted one of my clients to lie for him under oath. He offered me money. I refused. That night, as I was leaving my office, I was attacked. A bag was shoved over my head. I was hogtied. I was driven out into the desert. And when they pulled the hood off, I was kneeling in front of an open grave with a gun pointed at my head. That was my introduction to Walter White. I was terrified. But not for long. That night I saw opportunity. I shot at big money. And I grabbed it and I held it tight. And for the next 16 months, my every waking moment was spent building Walter White's drug empire.
Hold on, Mr. Goodman, stop right there. Consult Mr. Oakley before you say another word.
Your Honor, I believe the court deserves the whole truth.
You are contradicting your plea agreement's sworn factual basis.
No offense, Your Honor, but I think I know the law here better than you do.
Your Honor, we'd like to request a recess.
No, we do not need a recess.
Your Honor, we are satisfied for Mr. Goodman to continue.
Your Honor, I'd like to petition to withdraw from this case.
Denied.
Respectfully.
Not a chance. Bobby, swear Mr. Goodman in.
Do you swear that the evidence you shall give to the court in this matter shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
Mr. Goodman, you are now under oath. Any false statement you make can be used in prosecution for perjury or obstruction of justice. Do you understand?
Yes.
All right. In the last 24 hours, have you used any alcohol or other drugs?
No, Your Honor.
Are you taking any prescription medications?
No.
All right. Continue.
I lied to the government about Kim Wexler. I fed him a load of BS about her involvement in Howard Hamlin's murder. I just wanted her to come here today. I wanted her to hear this. So yeah, I wasn't there when the meth was cooked. I wasn't there when it was sold. I didn't witness any of the murders, but I damn well knew what was happening. I was more than a willing participant. I was indispensable. I kept Walter White out of jail. I laundered his money, I lied for him, I conspired with him, and I made millions. If he hadn't walked into my office that day, Walter White would have been dead or behind bars within a month. And Agent Schrader, and Agent Gomez, and a whole lot of other people would still be alive. Fact is, Walter White couldn't have done it without me. You got that?
Your Honor, we move to strike Mr. Goodman's comments.
On what grounds?
Speculation.
Speculation? He's testifying to his own actions.
Your Honor, he's describing events that would have transpired had he acted differently.
I have one more thing to say.
Sit down, Mr. Goodman.
Please, Your Honor.
Now.
Please, Your Honor.
Marshall,
the government urges the court to allow Mr. Goodman to continue.
How is that not speculation?
All right, Mr. Goodman. Go ahead.
What happened to Howard Hamlin? It was, I can't even. After that, Kim had the guts to start over. She left town, but I'm the one who ran away. And my brother, Chuck, Charles McGill, you may have known him. He was an incredible lawyer, as the most brilliant guy I ever met, but he was limited. I tried. I could have tried harder. I should have. Instead, when
Your Honor,
Bill, please, just let me get through this. Instead, when I saw a chance to hurt him, I took it. I got his malpractice insurance canceled. I took away the one thing he lived for, the law. After that, he killed himself. And I'll live with that.
What was all that? That thing with your brother, that wasn't even a crime.
It was.
Mr. Goodman, sit down and stay seated.
The name's McGill. I'm James McGill.
Your Honor, in view of the defendant's
Honor, like
confession, the government draws a sentencing recommendation and urges this court to impose the statutory maximum.
That was not a confession. It was
furthermore,
merely,
Your Honor, a second additional hearing is required
in
order to assess the additional claims Mr. Goodman, I'm sorry, Mr. McGill,
add,
has now admitted to, including perjury on this court,
evidence.